papers! My papers! It's Fantasy Downhill, presented by Trek. We got a lot to talk about, people. We kicked off the 2018 season in a place called Losinj, Croatia. I think it's pronounced Losinj. If not, we're gonna call it Losinj anyways, because it's fun to say. And what a race it was, man. It's gonna be tough. The hardest thing is gonna be waiting for the next race. We got like a couple months to go. It was a great way to kick off the 2018 UCI World Cup downhill season, and it was a great way to kick off the Pinkbike Fantasy Downhill presented by Trek. So let's talk about it. The ladies' field, first and foremost, top five for them. Cecile Ravenel in fifth, Maureen Caribou in fourth, Tawny Seagrave in third, Rachel Atherton in second, and Miriam McCaul taking the win by about 3.5 seconds. A couple notable items to talk about. One in particular is Cecile Ravenel. There's a stat, it's really impressive, so I want you to listen up. She's the only rider, men or women, to top 10 in an EWS race, in a UCI downhill race, and in a UCI cross country race. This fifth place here was her first podium in downhill. Another really interesting thing that happened, Valentina Hall. She's in the junior category, but her time was only 1.5 seconds off of the podium in the women's elite field. So keep your eye on her. I'm sure when she gets into the elite field, she's gonna be pretty pricey if she keeps this up. A big shakeup for a lot of you, I'm sure, was Tracy Hanna having that crash in her run. Say keep her on your team, because you can never count her out. On to the men, let's talk about the results. Fifth place, Dakota Norton, his best UCI downhill finish. Fourth place, Sam Blankensop. Third place, Dean Lucas. Then Luca Shaw and Aaron Gwynn rounding out the top two. Now I'm not gonna be obnoxious about this, but I have to do it. Three Americans in the top five. So let me just get this and wave my little flag. I'm just celebrating, it's exciting, okay? This is an interesting stat. Out of the 18,369 fantasy downhill participants, 6 out of the top 10 were American also. So it was a good week for the Americans. Hopefully we can keep this momentum rolling. There were a couple Canadians in the top 10 and then a few people who just don't have flags next to their little pink bike name. Get a flag, man. Get a flag so we know where you're from. Now, Aaron Gwynn was money well spent. The guy is not cheap if you want to have him on your team, but you'd be dumb not to. That's money well spent on Aaron Gwynn, everybody. He's like Old Faithful out there. And did you see that backflip? Yeah, Aaron Gwynn. Celebrating after the podium, he backflips. Look, check the shot out. Backflips off of that ledge, a dock or something, into the water. He's got like good style on it too. He's all corked out, his head all sideways. Rampage? Rampage for Aaron Gwynn. After he's won 40 World Cups, he might transition into Rampage. How much did he cost? He cost $625,000. Good investment. So let's talk about Brooke McDonald real quick. Didn't get any points for you guys, but he's looking so strong for this season. I'd say keep him on your team. He was the fastest in time training. He had the fastest qualifying run. And if you watched his race run up until that horrendous crash, man, was he ever looking quick? He was in the green, but every rider out there was saying they were just pushing themselves past the point of control, and Brooke, his point of control is so far past humans. And I feel bad for Brooke anytime I see him hit the ground, of course, let's say that first of all, but you feel worse for the ground. Can you imagine getting run into by Brooke McDonald? So a moment of silence for the ground. Let's talk about somebody who a lot of you guys out there believe in, for good reason, making his debut in the elite category. You know who I'm talking about. Finn Iles. 27% of you paid the money, got him on your team, but unfortunately, he had that crash. Man, he popped up so quick, but he ended up in 56th place because of that crash. I'd say keep spending the money on Finn Iles. That's bound to smooth out for him. So if you had Finn on your team, probably tripped you up a bit with him tripping up on his run, but not as much as if you had Loic Bruni on your team. People, what are you thinking? Now, I understand you never know what's gonna happen, but 11% of you had him on your team even though he announced before the race that he wasn't dropping in. You gotta pay attention to when the teams are locked and see what those riders are posting on their Instagram account. He didn't even race. You spent a lot of money on him. I'm talking hundreds of thousands of dollars. Your valuable fantasy dollars, poof, gone like this, poof, dust. That's your money. your fantasy money. We hope the best for Loic Bruni. Hopefully he's back up and running for Fort William. I'm sure he will be. He was considering racing in Loshen. I'm sure he'll be back in action in June for Fort William. Is it June? Clark, is June the next race? Who cares? It's Fort William. It's usually in June. So the rider with the most bang for the buck out there was without a doubt Eva Batolia. She only cost $25,000. She earned some points, and that's what fantasy downhill is all about. You gotta think outside the box. You gotta look at those time trainings, pay attention to the riders' Instagram accounts, and be smart like those of you who put Eva Batolia on your team and only spent $25,000 on her. Got some money, got some points. Come on! How am I supposed to know what I'm talking about if that keeps happening? Okay, I'll be right back. Now the wild card surprise of Losinj was definitely Dakota Norton. He cost $150,000, but he brought in 135 points. So way to go, all you out there who believe in the man, Dakota Norton. So enough about the racers. Let's talk about the people who really matter. We're talking about you, because this is the fantasy downhill results, not just the race results. There's plenty of places to tell you about that. The guy with the most points right now, I'm assuming he's a guy because his username is MoonboyMTB. Keep your pants on, Moonboy. It's a long season and you only have a 15-point lead over Tricycle Rider. Tricycle Rider. Moonboy and Tricycle Rider. Tricycle Rider has 900 points and rounding out the top three is William Cornelson 45. He's got 845 points. So if you really think about it, those 135 points people got for choosing Dakota Norton, 135 points is a lot when you consider that there's only 15 points separating top two. A lot of motivation out there to pay attention. I'm telling you, go to those riders' Instagram feeds and see what they're saying. If they're saying, oh, I felt horrible in practice, maybe you shouldn't spend your money on them. So Moonboy MTB, got great news for you. You won a spectacular prize. No, not a new username. You can do that on your own. You won a Bontrager line wheel set worth $1,200. So congrats. Put it on your bike. Go rip. Throw some roost. Those of you who didn't win a Bontrager line pro wheel set, you might want to do some research and figure out what Moonboy MTB was up to. So I got some information for you. He had Eva Batolia on his team. I told you about her. She only cost $25,000. Marine Cabaroo? Is it Caribou or Cabaroo? Maybe I messed it up earlier. Maybe it's one of those Losinj, fancy, fantasy things. I think it's Cabaroo. Is it Caribou? My neighbors are telling me how to pronounce her name. Do they watch downhill? Maybe that's Moonboy MTB over there. He also had Sam Blankensop, which cost him a cool $175,000. Lucas Shaw, he spent a quarter mil on him. Dakota Norton, $150,000, and he dropped the big bucks on Aaron Gwynn, $625,000 well spent. So I'm sure there are some big surprises for a lot of you out there who spent good money on some of the top riders and didn't get a lot of points out of it. Of course, we talked about Bruni, who was out from that practice crash. Brosnan got ninth. Finn had that crash for 56th. Danny Hart, 10th place, not bad, but not getting you very many points. Menar in 13th, so that was a big surprise. And in downhill, you just never know what's going to happen. That's why you got to be crafty out there if you want to win big prizes like that Bontrager Line Pro wheel set. That brings us to my pick, what I would advise you do for the next round. Not that I have any clue or that I know what I'm talking about in any way, shape, or form, but I'm supposed to do that. I'm supposed to give you some advice. If I were you, I would think about the track coming up. Next race, Fort William. It's a long track, a lot of pedaling. Just picture that final straightaway where they're scrubbing off those jumps, but they're sprinting across that flat before they get into that final pitch, leading you into the finish crowd with all the people losing their minds. Fireworks, a different flag, but so many fireworks. Where was I? Anyways, think about the track. Pay attention to what the riders are good at, their strengths. You gotta be fit for Fort William. So I'd also say look back at who would have done well if funny little mistakes or mechanicals didn't happen in Losinj. Take for example, Ed Masters. He was pinning it. He was in the green while Dakota was sitting in the hot seat. He had one visible mistake. Who knows, maybe there were more, but he also dropped his chain. So that's why he didn't get a good result. So take that out of the equation. He probably would have done pretty well. Probably would have been a good return on investment for you fantasiers out there. You fanciers out there, if you fancy winning prizes, I'd say put Ed Masters on your team for Fort William. Find out his address, send him the strongest chain you can buy just to make sure that doesn't happen again, and tell him no more mistakes because he obviously has what it takes. He got a That's why you guys edit. Yep, that's why you do it. He had a 12th place at the last EWS, and the dude's been training like crazy. He's mega fit right now. Take all those things and put them together. He looked really fast in Losinj, had a mechanical and a mistake. He got 12th at his last EWS. Fort William is a track where fitness means a lot. He's super fit right now. And you know what? He doesn't cost $625,000 like Aaron Gwynn. Not that I'm any sort of, what's the word? Pay for Ed Masters. That was your fantasy downhill recap for the first stop of the 2018 season. Hopefully you're hooked. Hopefully you're gonna participate in every single race this season. And hopefully you're gonna keep tuning in to watching me yammer on, filling you in on what you should have done and maybe what you did right in fantasy downhill. We'll see you next time. Go to graphics.